Huh?
Oh!
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Some people have been sort of looking at me funny because I keep saying humming a butt twice, actually. Until about 10 years ago, a lot of paleontologists would be surprised to hear me say that. So I get to kill two birds stone as far as requests go.
Today we're gonna shoot this little bit.
Dale, one of our local members, gave me a Therizinosaurus toy.
I had no choice. I tried planting the ants in your driveway, but they didn't take. They couldn't bite through cement. They're weak, like me.
And I know it's a Therizinosaurus toy because one, what else would this be? And two, it says it on the belly.
It's one word. Thesaurus. The Thesaurus. Sheesh.
Hey, I don't even know how to read.
And it is this.
What in God's name is that
monkey's
sound?
I ask you to look at modern birds and their elaborate mating rituals and humming a butt.
It's a mess in there!
Go figure that one. Barn. Sounds like I might be telling the truth.
It was such fragmentary remains, really all we had that was of substance was the butt, so he named it Butt Lizard. And then it wasn't until really the late 90s.
90s as fuck!
Jurassic Park! That's nothing, bro. I'm reading Goosebumps. Eat my shorts. VHS tape. Old school.
That we had enough specimens from both China and from...
America.
My nose itches!
Except that it can't, so it has to knuckle drag like those recon.
No restriction whatsoever.
Open the door, get on the boat. Everybody wants the dinosaur. Open the door, get on the boat. Everybody wants the dinosaur. Open the door, get on the boat. Everybody wants the dinosaur. Open the door, get on the boat. Everybody wants the dinosaur. Boom boom, akalaka laka boom. Boom boom, akalaka boom. Boom boom, akalaka laka boom. Boom boom, akalaka.
I'm gonna not do that fancy transition and I'm just gonna go into it, okay. That makes it more likely for a creature to mate, but
little piston, he stays centered, right there where he wants to be. But
continuing our journey upwards. But unfortunately a lot of the finer detailing is wrong. This particular toy, it looks like the manufacturer went to a lot of trouble to present Therizinosaurus as accurately as they could. It breaks my heart because they've actually gone to the trouble of depicting a theropod pubis that you see in a lot of more advanced Maniraptors. We're over 3 feet long, so that's pretty cool. About the only way that it could defend itself from predators would be to use its gigantic pubis. It was a much more compact package, unless it decided to lash out. They seem to have been one long pubis that they're maybe a little too small, and the shape of them is kind of screwy. That's mostly speculation at this point, but it is kind of cool that there's nothing to really dissuade from that interpretation.
Hurts my feelings, but it's just a fact.
Pubis that fur, don't discount the fluffiness. Hanging off of the pubis that with a bunch of fibers coming off of it, it could puff up rather fluffy. And there are a bunch of theories. I could do a whole episode on pubis that fur. I should mention that this guy was in the late Cretaceous because the the comparison that people keep making is ground sloths, which is not a terribly good name for those animals. I would prefer to call them chewing batteries. I would prefer to call them elephant bears. shouldn't say advanced, I should say derived, because it wasn't better, it was just more specialized. But there should be cheeks in the way. Tell me dinosaurs to take apart. Claws. So, shaft, and that's really something. The fact that it was a plant eater is right. I really don't have much problem with the,
A computer!
First question. Are you paranoid?
Who wants to know?
Scariest situation ever to be in.
Huge gut hanging out in front of it. Quit it! But, oh, first, I should mention the feet. Boring, in my opinion. Thank you, Dale, for giving me the Therizinosaurus.
And the pockets are big enough for an umbrella! Shh-sha! Umbrella! Shh-sha! Joseph will love it.
You can't stop it. It's all over.